Having to share the field or sacrifice important study time late at night to make practice is something intramural participants experience every year. By expanding the intramural field, university officials hope to make the experience more convenient for future participants. Director of University Recreation Jeremy Battjes believes this expansion is a big recruiting tool for future students.
I think being able to offer quality experiences for the activities they want to do gives them the break from school that they need, still participate in activities that not only provide health benefits to students, but there's leadership opportunities, there's social interaction.
We have 9-acre fields, and according to campus recreational planning standards, the fields need to be 3 times that size. The expansions will be at Cato Springs, Razorback Road, and they hope to acquire land behind Chick-fil-A on MLK. Battjes says the new fields, paid for with student fees, will allow more playing time for students, even in the face of bad weather.
Some will be artificial turf and some will be natural turf. Again, the artificial turf offers us the guarantee that we can play. You know, if we get a pour down rain all week, but they have a game Saturday, you know, we're still going to be able to play.
Allison Sims, president of the Women's Rugby Club, says not only does weather affect the rugby team, but sharing the field with so many other sports reduces practice time.
Right now we only have one field, which is kind of hard since we have so many outdoor teams. We have to split time for practices. Practice times are very competitive.
For the Razorback Reporter, I'm Ginny Monk.